Thanks for checking out this unboxing video. This is for the April BAMBOX Pop Culture Box. I always get thrown off on this because these boxes never show up during the actual month that they're named for, which has always been a thing that's really just kind of thrown me off. I'm like, why would it be the April if it's we're getting it in May? And it's always been like that. So I've always kind of felt like they should just like change the name on it, and they should just be like, this one would be the May one because you're actually getting it in May. I mean, I understand that that's when they're shipping it, and that's when people are paying for it is in that month, but it just seems a little weird to, like, get it and be like, this is for the previous month. I don't know, just a thing. But as I've said, this is the box. It's much bigger because there's supposed to be a signed pop in here, which if you watch my other pop culture unboxing for last month, you'll know I think it's a cool idea. I think it's a great idea to do the autographs with pops when you can make that happen. So I'm pretty excited for this. But this is also my last of the BAMBOX pop culture boxes just because I'm not going forward with it because there have been ups and downs with the box. Overall, I like the box. The problem is I'm just not huge into a lot of the pop culture franchises they've been doing. I think the stuff is cool. I just am not really going to display it. So I want to focus more on the things that I really like, which is horror. So I will still be getting the BAM horror box. And in addition, I'm replacing this pop culture box with Fright Crate just to get more horror stuff to unbox. But something I keep forgetting to say on these videos that I really should say is that I can send people a link. It's like a referral link where you can get some money off your first BAM box, whether it's the pop culture or the horror, your choice. So just send me an email at brutalbattlepodcast@gmail.com, and brutal is spelled B-R-E-W-T-A-L. Brutal Battle is actually a craft beer podcast that I do and have been doing for over 6 years now. So if you have interest, you can also check that out. But brutalbattlepodcast@gmail.com. Tell me you just want the referral link. I'll send it to you and get some money off, and it actually goes to help me. So anyway, let's get into this box, my last of the pop culture boxes. The way these are laid out. Oh, okay, so this is upside down. All right, tissue paper for the cat. Two pieces of tissue paper? Three pieces of tissue paper. The more the better. Keep the cat happy. Oh, a fourth. Bonus. Actually, I think this is the first time there's been four in there. Cat will be happy. Okay. This feels like a lanyard, which haven't had a lanyard in here, like, ever, I don't think. So that's fine with me, honestly. If they're doing something, like, I'm not big on lanyards in the first place, but if they're doing something that they haven't done, which, like I said, I don't think they've done a lanyard before. Oh, no, they did one. Well, it was more of like an ID badge. And that's fine. But at any rate, they're doing something new. I'm down with it. So this is for Jurassic Park. It is a visitor badge for Jurassic Park. Same thing on the other side. And as you can see, it's a lanyard. You can just wear it if you want. I'm fine with that. That's fine. I don't have a problem with it. You know, it's their prop thing. So as far as the props go, this is actually something that I might display as opposed to a lot of the other props that I'm typically not big on. But I'm fine with that. No problem there. The pin. Okay, it's up against the side. Found it. All right, so this is done by Tom Ryan Studios. And this is a Shazam pin, which, by the way, I've not seen Shazam yet. I've heard it's actually a solid film, like a lot of fun. It seems like they just kind of went more towards like comedy and a good light time. So from what I'm hearing, one of the better DC superhero movies. What the heck? Okay, so maybe there's a reference I'm not getting here, but I know he like during one of the trailers that I saw, he was like chewing bubblegum. So I guess that's what it is, but it actually kind of looks like with the way that his upper lip is shaped, like he's trying to like eat a giant red ball, which is kind of weird. But I like the shape of it. I like that it's like a non-typical shape. I think that's kind of cool when they kind of go outside of the box on like the overall outlining shape of the pin itself. I think that's pretty cool because you do see a lot of pins that are just more like square or circular or something like that. So to be a little more interesting is cool. That's fine. I'm down. I do want to do... I think I'm going to do the pop last, so it's going to be a little hard to get stuff out from under, but... All right, so the... Oh, okay. So I'll be interested to see when I flip this over what this looks like, because obviously I saw Endgame, Avengers Endgame. I'm sure a lot of people at this point have. It's made all the money. So this is an art print for Endgame done by Anthony Goodsell. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, man. That is... That's cool. I guess maybe I got a one-up. Did I get a one-up? I feel for it. I don't know if I did. I don't think I got like a little one-up thing. But this is out of 500. I got number 129 out of 500. Look at this. That's a really cool Thanos print. That is... I might actually put that on my wall. I legitimately think that's cool. I like that. Sorry for the glare. But look at this. Like... You know, and it's interesting because, like, some people might look at this and be like, you know, I kind of want it, like, scaled back a little bit so you can see all of them. But I actually like it this way where it's kind of just, like, zooming in on him so you just see a portion of the hand. Like, it's cool. Like, the pose is really awesome. The art looks really good. This is probably... This is one of the best art prints I've gotten from their pop culture box, for sure. I think the other one that I really liked was the Death of Gwen Stacy one with Spider-Man, like, holding her. It was in, like, black and white. That was the other one that I thought was really awesome. So this one is, like, that's pretty awesome. And people who were really psyched about Endgame and really liked Endgame, probably really going to like this print. Good job to Anthony Goodsell. That's really nice, man. I dig it. That's cool. So that makes me think I'm going out on top here with this box. Okay, so I think, yes. So it's just the pop is the end of it. All right, so the pop is, actually the pop's a little messed up, but they did put it in a pop protector, which is good, is very good. The pop itself has a little bit of damage on the box. It's not too bad, but I really dig that they're putting it in a pop protector. So I got Woody Woodpecker done by... signed by Eric Bauza, who has voiced numerous characters, Woody Woodpecker being one of them. So if you can see on the top, that's where they're putting their COA. Like I said, for the horror unboxing, they just started doing like actual like lettered numbers for the ability for people to go online and verify the COA. So that's pretty awesome. And here's the Woody Woodpecker. I'm sorry for all the glare, but here's the Woody Woodpecker pop. Signature looks good, especially where it's put. I like it. I mean, the actual Woody Woodpecker pop, in my opinion, doesn't look like super awesome. I mean, it's okay. It's kind of simplistic, the pop itself. But once again, like I said, I really dig the idea of BAM going out and buying pops and getting people to sign them for the autographs. It's a super cool thing. And even though I'm not like big on who this dude is, or big on Woody Woodpecker. I did watch it when I was a kid, though. I just think it's a really cool thing to have. And the other thing is, like, down the road, if I feel like I ever want to get rid of it, this increases the value of the pop pretty decently for anyone who really wants, you know, a Woody Woodpecker pop. Because if people see it, people are like, oh, I really want a Woody Woodpecker pop. And then they're like, you can get it not signed, or you can get it signed by someone who did the voice. What are you going to choose? Yeah, and then once again, the fact that they're putting them in pop protectors is key, especially with the way the U.S. Postal Service lately has been handling my packages, which this package was actually in pretty good shape, but had they not been putting these in pop protectors, I was going to be super nervous getting this box, because I never know what the U.S. Postal Service is going to do, so good on BAM for putting them in protectors. So, yeah, I just think this is super cool. I'm excited. I like it. Okay, so now the spoiler sheet, because empty. Throw that over there for now. Ooh, sorry, that may have made a very large noise. Okay, so there were three different versions of the pin. I think the limited out of 250 looks like the coolest, in my opinion. You see that one up here? Because it's like a little anime-ish. I think it looks pretty cool. And then the one out of 99 is pretty sweet. But I think the one out of 250 is the coolest. Okay, the... I'm trying to figure out what the... Okay. So the only difference on the art print for the special ones, as you can see. I don't even know if you're going to be able to tell in this video, but the difference is just like the coloration in the background. In the background only, which is kind of crappy. This is one of my gripes about the like rarer art prints is when they're just doing like a slight color difference. It's not a difference. It's really not a difference to me. So, I mean, sure, the numbering like actually makes it rarer, and there are people out there who would be interested in it. But the picture doesn't really look different at all. So, like, for someone like me, I'm not interested in that difference. It just seems like it's all the same, in my opinion. But what would have been cool, though, actually, is if, like, a small change they could have made is, like, change the color of the Infinity Stones that are actually in the print. That would have been a kind of a better way of kind of, like, changing color but making it more interesting. I don't know. Just an idea. Then there were the badges. I mean, they look, you know, look the same. Like I said, I'm fine with those badges. They haven't done it before. I'm down with that. Then the pops, since this guy has voiced a lot of cartoons, there were a few different pops you could get. And I know they had some really super limited ones. They had the gold Spider-Man on here that some people could have gotten. That one would have been super, super, super sweet to get, because the value on that, I guarantee, will go up pretty decently. That's pretty cool. And then they would always do these giveaways. So their giveaway was for a Tom Holland signed Spider-Man Homecoming 8x10. Super awesome. I'm sorry, my hands are a little shaky today. It's my actual condition, essential tremor, where I can't control it. But the good thing about having that condition is that it lessens your chances of getting Parkinson's. So that's good. But you know, I'll tell you, like, on the topic of Tom Holland and Spider-Man, I love Tom Holland as Spider-Man. Also, I love Spider-Man Homecoming. I think that's a really awesome film. I feel like a lot of people, when I talk to them about it, they're like, oh yeah, I really like that. But when people are talking about, like, what are some of your favorite Marvel films, I feel like Homecoming doesn't come up a whole lot, but it's easily in my top, I can't quite say top five, but easily top 10, closer to top five than 10. It's an awesome film. So, Michael Keaton in there, unbelievable. I'm very excited for Far From Home. Very excited, because Jake Gyllenhaal always does an excellent job, and the fact that they're bringing Mysterio in, super cool. So anyway, thank you everyone for checking this out. I do apologize if there are people out there who are really liking my unboxings of the Pop Culture Box, because I'm discontinuing it. This was the last one. I felt like this was a good one to go out on. Like I said, that print was one of the best pop culture prints that has ever been in this box. Awesome, Anthony Goodsell. You should be proud of yourself for that. The signed pop, super cool. And the fact that it's in a protector, very cool. The pin was solid. The lanyard for a prop, I'm totally down with. It's good. Plus, Jurassic Park, man. Cool property. But yeah, so I do apologize if people are really looking forward to this. I mean, you can give me that feedback. I might go back at some point if things are super interesting to me, but I don't know. I know next month, the one for May that people will get in June, they were saying that the autograph they're really excited about. So part of me was like, yeah, I'm going to miss it. But I'm like, it is what it is. So seek out other unboxers to watch their reactions to those things. But know that I'm still doing the horror box through BAM, and I am doing Fright Crate, which I should be getting my Fright Crate in the next day or so. So, actually, it wouldn't come on Sunday, most likely, but day or so, I mean today or like Monday, Tuesday, something like that. So, soon, very soon, and I'm excited about that. But anyway, thank you everyone for checking this out. Please hit that subscribe. It can mean a lot for my channel. It means very little time-wise for you, only like, you know, a second to make that happen. Hit the notification bell so you know every time I'm putting up videos, because I'm doing a bunch of movie reviews and stuff like that. Did a trailer reaction review, a trailer review for the It Chapter 2 trailer, which looks phenomenal. Put some comments down there. We can talk about nerdy stuff, and give me some thumbs up if you want to, your choice. But thank you everyone so much, and until next time, keep it brutal.